Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Navya and now I'm going to discuss with you about hypoxemia. So let us start with its definition. Hypoxemia is reduction in partial pressure of the arterial oxygen content, right? So this small a here represents the arterial oxygen. Just to avoid some confusion, let us differentiate it from hypoxia, which is a more vague term and refers to reduction in oxygen content in the tissues, right? So this can be due to various causes including hypoxemia. So hypoxemia can lead to hypoxia, but it is not the same as hypoxia. So now to understand the causes of hypoxemia, we first need to know where this arterial oxygen is coming from, right? So let us just follow this simple flowchart here. So we have P inspired oxygen first of all. So the air that we breathe in contains some oxygen, and this is referred to as P partial pressure of inspired oxygen, right? So this air now enters the alveolus, and from the alveolus it crosses the capillary and the alveolar membranes, and it reaches the pulmonary veins, right? From the pulmonary veins, the pulmonary venous blood then reaches the left heart, and from the left heart the blood is pumped into the arteries, and that is where we give the partial pressure of arterial oxygen. So these are the various steps. Now let us look at each step in a little more detail, starting with the partial pressure of inspired oxygen. So we know that the partial pressure of any given gas in a gaseous mixture is equal to the fraction of the given gas in the total gas mixture into the total pressure, right? So applying the same thing here, the partial pressure of inspired oxygen is given by the fraction of inspired oxygen into the atmospheric pressure, and that is the total pressure under normal conditions, and we are subtracting water vapor pressure from it, because as we inspire the air, it is some humidity is added to it in the upper respiratory tract, so we don't want that to interfere with our oxygen calculation, inspired air oxygen, so we are subtracting it. So this gives us the partial pressure of oxygen in the inspired air. This same inspired oxygen is entering the alveolus, the partial pressure does not remain the same, because it's not just the oxygen here in the alveolus, you also have carbon dioxide, so you have another major content being added, so that will definitely affect the oxygen tension. So how is that affecting? You'll have partial pressure of inspired oxygen minus PaCO2 by respiratory quotient. So respiratory quotient is a minor topic which can be discussed later, but the more important one here is partial pressure of arterial carbon dioxide, right? Now this is what you have in the alveolus. So this much oxygen in the alveolus will now diffuse across the diffusing membrane, which is formed by the alveolar membrane and the capillary membrane. So once this crosses, you'll have the pulmonary capillary oxygen. Now the pulmonary capillaries drain into the pulmonary veins, and you'll have pulmonary venous oxygen. Right. So what are the factors playing role here in the process of the alveolar oxygen entering the pulmonary capillaries? One thing is the ventilation perfusion ratio. So we know that any ventilation without perfusion or perfusion without ventilation is of no use, right? So you should have a well ventilated alveolus with a good perfusion in order for the diffusion to happen. If anyone is missing, there's no use. So this matching is necessary. Ventilation perfusion ratio should be good enough, should be nearing one in order for the diffusion to happen. Then the second thing is the direct diffusion itself. So this diffusion is affected by various parameters, a few of them including surface area of the diffusing membrane, then the thickness of the diffusing membrane, and then the pressure gradient. So these are the factors, various factors that play a role in the diffusion across the alveolar and the capillary membrane. then finally a physiological shunt happens, which is because of the draining of the bronchial veins into the left heart instead of into the right heart. So like any other vein in the body, bronchial veins also carry deoxygenated blood, but instead of draining into the right side of the heart, they're draining into the left side of the heart. So that will lead to a little desaturation of the blood.